Hi, I'm Nathan Zampronio, one of your Hawkesbury City Councillors. Tonight at Council, we dealt with the issue of raising Warragamba Dam and whether our Council should take a view on that project. This is a subject that I've been going on about for a very long time, on TV.
Well, for this community, it's a matter of life and death.
Local councillor Nathan Zamprogno has had enough and wants his community protected.
If we can ensure against the severity of a bad flood by 75% for under $1 billion, when you look at a potential damage bill of between $7 and $10 billion, to me that seems like money well spent. Who would seek to squash this project based on this false premise that this is an ulterior way of bringing more development into the floodplain? And I don't want to see that happen either.
Nathan Zambrogno's ancestor was killed in floods in this area. The council has been campaigning for the wall to be lifted for years.
But you have to balance the risks to the environment upstream with the potential catastrophic loss of life and property downstream.
On radio.
And it particularly irks me that people who are not in the bullseye, who are not subject to the risk of a flooding event, can pontificate on our behalf and tell us that we should endure a great risk. It's easy to be morally righteous when you're high and dry and out of harm's way.
Nathan, good to talk to you. Thank you for making the state government's case when the Minister for Western Sydney and the New South Wales Environment Minister were unavailable.
And in the press. You see, the Hawkesbury has the highest risk of flooding of any catchment in Australia. There are 130,000 people that live and trade on our floodplain. And in March, we got a very sharp reminder of the effects of flooding. That flood that we had in March wasn't a particularly big one, about 1 in 20 as far as the probability goes in any given year. But what we were talking about tonight was the release of the Environmental Impact Statement, a new document, 8,092 pages worth, that puts the detailed engineering and ecological case for the project.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Look, I think the only appropriate way to frame this debate is to acknowledge that it used to be an article of faith that successive chambers and successive mayors took it as the most obvious thing in the world that, of course, we as a council, representing the most flood-prone area in Australia, would support flood mitigation to safeguard the life and property of people in our area. It is only since the election of this council in 2016 that that situation has changed.
That EIS turns up some pretty startling new data. For example, one of the things that we now know is that in the March flood, 600 houses were flooded out. But if those mitigation works had been in place years ago, only 100 houses would have been flooded, because the flood would have been a full 3.5 metres lower than what we saw. This makes me think of people like Lisa and Ben, who live in North Street in Windsor and whose house was flooded to the second story. If these mitigation works had been in place years ago, their house would have been completely spared.
It's a case of us, you know, having a whinge about, you know, more development and things like that. It's more about the impact that that's having.
Yeah. And
also, I know that the Warragamba Dam isn't a flood mitigation dam, but at the same time, there's certain levels of responsibility with that, because it's let out too late and then it comes down with or...
This is the human cost of our inaction to get underway with proper flood mitigation.
So there are 500 houses, 500 families, who would have been spared.
For the last 5 years on this council, left-leaning councillors, the Labor and the Greens and the left-leaning independents, have reversed council's long-held position in favour of flood mitigation works. But they've always been fairly reluctant to admit as much. So they've used terms like, oh, well, we need to wait for the EIS. Oh, there isn't enough data out there. Never mind that the EIS that was produced at very great length in the 1990s took 7 years to compile and was ratified by any number of international and independent experts. But now we're here with a new EIS, and those who have hidden behind the excuse of waiting for more data no longer have that excuse. I feel that they have an obligation to declare their position for or against flood safety in the Hawkesbury before the next local government election. Instead, what we got were tired old tropes, things that have been refuted 1,000 times, things in fact that stand in complete contradiction to the findings of both the EIS and the testimony offered by a range of public officials and ministers before the New South Wales Upper House inquiry. For example, that it would be more cost-effective to build desalination plants. They're wrong. Or that we should lower the permanent storage level of the dam to provide the same degree of flood mitigation. Also wrong. Or that this is really a stalking horse for development on the floodplain. I'm on the record as being against inappropriate development on the floodplain, and I'm satisfied that all of the officials and the testimony that was given to that public inquiry makes it abundantly clear that flood height controls will not be changed, that this is not about desterilising a single square inch that is currently prohibited for development on the floodplain. This is about safety and property of people's livelihoods and homes.
It's also useful to recognise that the EIS recognises and gives some time to examining the ecology downstream from the dam. This is often portrayed as a false dichotomy between the ecology upstream and the built environment and the human cost downstream. But there is an ecology downstream from the dam that would be damaged, and where there are species that are less flood resilient than what the EIS does declare, and that is that they've looked at the flood resilience of the species fringing Lake Borogarang and have concluded that that those species will endure an inundation, a temporary inundation, of the scale that would occur if the dam were to be raised on those very rare occasions.
Tonight, the Mayor, Patrick Connolly, brought a mayoral minute, suggesting that our council should make a submission to the process that's underway for the EIS until the end of November.
The Mayor has brought a mayoral minute saying, look, there's a public submission process. Obviously, this council should put together a submission. Here are the things that we should be mindful of. I only wish that this mayoral minute was a clear declaration from this council to reaffirm its support for flood mitigation. But it isn't that.
I am incredibly disappointed to tell you that a majority of councillors voted against even making a submission on behalf of our community to that submission process.
So I'll put the motion. All those in favour, please raise your hand. In favour of Councillor Connolly, Councillor Zamprogno, Councillor Richards, Councillor Tree. Against? Councillor Calvert, Councillor Lyons-Bucket, Councillor Reynolds, Councillor Rasmussen, Councillor Wheeler, Councillor Collash, Councillor Ross, Councillor Garry not present for the vote. Declare it lost.
I often remark that the people who oppose raising Warragamba Dam are often not even people who live in the Hawkesbury. We're the community that's in the bullseye. We're the community that suffers from flood risk. Whereas those people are often living up in the Blue Mountains or in the eastern suburbs and who are high and dry and out of harm's way. It's Hawkesbury Council's responsibility to represent the interests of people in our area. We're the ones at risk of flooding. We're the ones who have to live with the river.